Who are the six Goswamis of Vrindavan?
Who are the six Goswamis of Vrindavan?
You don't know? Srila Sanatan Goswami, Srila Rupa Goswami, Sri Raghunatha Bhatta Goswami, Sri Raghunath Das Goswami, Sri Chiva Goswami, Sri Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Right? So let's practice this shloka. Nana Shastra Vicharinayaka Nipuno Sadharma Samsthapako.
Nana Shastra Vicharanaika Nipuno Sadharma Samsthapako
Lokanam Hitakarino Tribhuvane Manyo Sharanyakaro
Lokanam Hitakarino Tribhuvane
Radha Krishna Padaravinda Bhajana Nandena Mattalikam
Radha Krishna Padaravinda Bhajana Nandena Mattalikam
Vande Rupa Sanatana Raghuyuga Shri Jiva Gopalaka
Vande Rupa Sanatana Raghu Yuga Shri Jiva Gopalaka.
Nice. So today we have a new team member, Abhishek Mishra, who moved from India a few years ago. He lives in Mill Creek, in the northern side of Bhopal. So Abhishek Prabhu, do you want to introduce yourself to the group?
Hare Krishna. Thanks Prabhuji. So as Prabhuji said, like I am living in Mill Creek area. I work in Amazon, and I moved to US in like early 2017. So it has been around like four and a half years now. And I am here living with my daughter, my little son, 8-year daughter, my 2-year son, and my wife.
Very good. Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
So what we did was, normally we discuss Bhagavad Gita, but today for a change, I wanted to talk a little bit about the six Goswamis of Vrindavan. So Nana Shastra Vicharanaika Nipuno. Shastra means scriptures, Vicharana means doing research, Nipuno means expert. Sadharma Samsthapako. So they are re-establishing the principles of religion, because at that time India was under the grip of Muslim rule. If we didn't have Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and these six Goswamis, we will all be chanting Allahu Akbar by now. Right? So these people re-established the principles of Dharma. Radha Kund and Sham Kund were covered up in the Vrindavan area. People did not even know exactly where Radha Kund and Sham Kund were. Like, there were some cowherds here and there, sheep, taking care of sheep and cows. But they did not exactly know where these devotional places were. Everything was covered up with mud. So these six Goswamis, primarily Srila Sanatana Goswami and Srila Rupa Goswami, they were the disciples of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the modern times has given us the spirit of devotion. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Rai discussing about what is the highest science on the banks of River Godavari in Rajahmundry in Andhra. They said, okay, the highest mantra for this age is the Hare Krishna mantra. And the highest devotion is that of devotion of the gopis to Krishna. Initially, they talk about Hanuman's devotion. They talk about, various types of devotion by different kings. And then finally, they conclude. I mean, it's a big topic, actually. Their discussion lasts for many days. And finally, they come to the conclusion that the highest form of worship of the Supreme Lord in the Kali Yuga is chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had these disciples, Sanatana Goswami and Rupa Goswami. They were working for the Muslim government. They even changed their names, Dhabir Khas and Sakar Malik. So back then, the situation was so bad that people would cover their real Vedic name and take on these Muslim names. So they were named Dhabir Khas and Sakar Malik. And they were given pretty good salary, actually. I mean, they were the prime ministers of the Nawab of Bengal. And every year the Nawab would give one small boatload full of gold coins. That was his salary. When most people were making one gold coin an entire year, they were given a small boatload of gold coins for these brothers because they were important people. They were collecting taxes. They were administering the kingdom and literally took on Muslim names. Then they came in contact with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is none other than Krishna himself, obviously, they could not resist Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When he was speaking, they simply became his disciples. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu entrusted them with finding out all these punyakshetras. Of course, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself, right? He knows where they are, but he wanted to engage his disciples to do the anveshan, to figure out where things are. And then they figured out, and then they re-excavated the Radha Kund and Sham Kund. They built many, many temples. Radha Madan Mohanji, Radha Gopalji, Radha Govindji. So like in the Aarti, we normally sing, Jaya Radha Govinda Radha Govinda Radhe. Jaya Radha Gopinath Radha Gopinath Radhe. Jaya Radha Madan Mohan Radha Madan Mohan Radhe. Why? Why do we refer to these three temples? These are the most important temples. Sambandha, Abhidheya and Prayojana. These are advanced topics. I don't expect you to understand what Sambandha, Abhidheya, Prayojana is. SAP. Sambandha means our relationship. Abhidheya means the process to invigorate that relationship. And Prayojana means the result that we get by re-establishing our relationship with Krishna. The reason we won't understand these things is because we are watching TV, maybe eating a burger, some chicken sandwich, this, that, right? As people progressively give up these bad habits of eating meat, drinking alcohol, watching TV, then these subject matters will enter our brain. Because the brain is finite, right? You cannot have everything in it. So if you are preoccupied with these material topics, then the spiritual topics have no place to enter, no entry. So we have to give those things up in order for us to understand these higher subject matters. So that's why they say, unless you are in the mode of goodness, you cannot understand this subject matter, right? Mode of ignorance means drinking alcohol, eating meat. Mode of passion means working too hard to make a lot of money. So in the mode of ignorance and passion, our channels, right? Just like a radio, when you switch it on, there are channels that come through. So our channels are all blocked. So to unblock those channels, you have to have a certain level of purity. And then these channels are unblocked. I mean, there is continuous program relay from the spiritual world. But why are we unable to tap it? Because we have blocked our channels. Right. So when we slowly, gradually unblock, and how does the unblocking happen? By the mercy of a spiritual master. Till such time that you have a blood and flesh spiritual master from whom you take initiation or diksha, you will take Srila Prabhupada as your spiritual master. And he's speaking through these pages. Right now you are looking at your guru who is speaking through his pages. Right. So whether I speak or you have a natural language processing speak, Doesn't matter. It's still Prabhupada's vani that is coming through. Right? In the companies, they use NLP, NLU, AI algorithms to kind of speech to text, tech to speech. So this text can be converted to speech by a human being or by an artificial intelligence algorithm. Regardless, it is still Prabhupada speaking. And what is he saying? These acharyas who have taken shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So how did they take shelter? Lokanam hitakari nao tribhuvane manyau sharanyakaro. What is there called? Lokanam hitakarine. Hita means well wishes. So Srila Prabhupada in all his letters he used to sign, your ever well wisher. Nobody in the world has signed like that. Mostly people say sincerely, faithfully, best regards. Only Srila Prabhupada signed like this. Your well-wisher. And in matter of fact, he was our well-wisher. He is our well-wisher. Because although physically he is not there, his vani or his words are there with us today. So lokanam hitakarinam means for all the planetary systems, for various lokas, for their hita means hit, as they say in Hindi, for their benefit. Tribhuvane, not only these our planetary systems, but higher planetary systems and lower planetary systems. Like Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Tala, Atala, Rasatala, Mahatala, Patala. They are all lower planetary systems. Higher planetary systems are Bhur, Bhuvar, Swaha, Tapa, Jana, Mahar, and Satyalokas. So for these upper, lower, and middle, for their hit, these people came. And what are they doing? They are taking Sharanya of what? Sharan means shelter of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is none other than Krishna incarnated for the Kali Yuga. And there is one more Yuga avatar coming. His name is Kalki avatar. Kalki avatar won't say, Hare Baba, chant Hare Krishna. He has a thunderbolt in his hand and he will chop off people by the millions. So he'll come and within one and a half hour, the entire planet Earth, everybody is chopped off. And then Kali Yuga will end and Satyuga will start. Right? So right now he came as a nice guy. Later on, he will come as a dangerous incarnation. Kalki avatar. So I posted an article about Kalki. Right? So let me show you my article. So Abhishek ji, if you have LinkedIn, you can send me a meeting invite because I have like a lot of people. I'm not allowed to send meeting invites anymore. I have like 5,500 something contacts already. So you please send me a meeting invite and we can connect. I believe Shesh Dev is already connected with me. And Jaypal is also connected. Disha is yet to establish her LinkedIn account. It only takes 10 seconds, Mataji, to just go there, put in your email address, boom, you are there. So if you look at articles, what I talked about there, I mean, I talk about a variety of things like Sita Ki Rasoi, how certain Muslims acknowledge that Ram Janmabhoomi was there. And then I talk about these Kalpa, Manvantara, Divya Yuga, the calculations in Yuga cycles. And this is where I talked about Kalki Avatar. So Kalki Avatar, you see, he has this blazing weapon in his hand. And at the end of Kali Yuga, he'll come and chop off everybody's heads. It is said that he will kill at the speed of mind. So he will say, okay, Samamish, cut, 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 everybody's cut. Redmond, cut, 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 everybody's finished. Bellevue, cut, 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 everybody's finished. Delhi, everybody's finished. Amritsar, everybody's finished. Right? Islamabad, everybody's finished. Like that, city by city, everybody is finished. That is how it works during when Kalki comes on board. So right now he hasn't come as Kalki. He has come as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, Are Baba, please chant Hare Krishna. I'll take you home. I am not prepared for the exam. Okay. Just you know, 40% is pass mark. You just write 39% worth of material. I will add 1% and I'll make you pass. Right? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is after us. He is basically literally begging us to chant the holy name of Krishna. Kalki is not like that. Kalki is not like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When Kalki comes, he comes with a different force. He will just simply chop off heads. So, any questions, thoughts on this topic, concept? So, if you die now and we take birth again, which we are all going to take unless we become serious in devotion, me included. If we come back again, there'll be even more dangerous Kali Yuga coming later. So you cannot even do the little chanting we are doing right now. And then if you come towards the end of Kali Yuga, then there is no devotion left. Right? Everybody is a barbarian. People are cutting each other and eating them like that. Cannibalism like that. So we have to wake up when there is still time. Later on, there may not be time left. So, the author is writing that I offer my respectful obeisance unto the six Goswamis. What are they? Very expert in scrutinizingly studying all these scriptures. They're very, very expert. And what is that? Radha Krishna Padaravinda Bhajana Nandena Mattaliko. Radha Krishna Padaravinda. At their feet, what are you doing? You're doing bhajan. But bhajan is not easy. First, you have to come to the bhajan status, first you have to do what? Abhishek, do you know what is the very first step in the cycle?
Like for bhajan?
Yeah. What are the various stages?
I am not sure.
Okay. So the first step is, when you come in association with devotees. That's what we are doing right now. Then comes Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastra Koi, Lava Matra Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Hoi. Lava means 1/6 of a second. If you associate with a pure devotee for 1/6 of a second, your devotional juices will keep going. So, first step is you have some interest. And because of that interest, you do sadhu sangha. Then comes bhajana kriya. Then comes anartha nivritti. Most people on this planet will spend most of their life in anartha nivritti. Means getting rid of bad qualities. Right? Some people will say, one person was saying, yeah, Prabhuji, without egg, I cannot survive. She used to come to my classes 10 years ago. Still, she's, not been able to give up her egg eating habit. Right? Different people are like different problems they have. One person was telling me that he has sexual problems. He cannot really overcome that. Right? So he'll be there in the same stage for a very long time. So in this way, everybody has some problems, and by trying to fix that is the anartha nivritti stage, which is not easy. Anartha nivritti is a long drawn process. Then comes nishta, asakti, ruchi, bhava, prema. And in prema, there are six levels. And the reason we don't cover all those advanced levels is because we are always struggling between sadhu sangha and bhajana kriya. Once in a while, we are getting rid of one of our bad habits called anartha nivritti. So we are always in levels 1, 2, and 3. So if somebody is in first grade, second grade, third grade, if you talk about PhD level topics, would it make sense? Anisha, would it make sense?
No, it definitely wouldn't make sense. Yeah.
So first, let's finish our first grade, second grade, third grade, and then we can go to this. So even bhajan, to do proper bhajan, we have to go through the first stage. We are already there. Second stage, which is sadhu sangha, which is what we are doing. Then comes bhajana kriya. So then the author says, Vande Roop Sanatano Raghu Yugo Shri Jiva Gopalako. Vande Roop Sanatan. Roop is Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami, Raghunath Bhatta Goswami. Gopala Bhatta Goswami, and then finally Jiva Goswami. In terms of writing literature, Rupa, Sanatana, and Jiva Goswami are the best authors. So their names are usually encountered more. Right? So, Nana Shastra Vicharnaika Nipuno. They have read all kinds of Shastras. Nana means all of them. Vicharnaika, they researched everything. And then their Saddharma Samstapako, they are establishing the principles of dharma. For what? Lokanam hitakarino. For the welfare of the lokas. Tribhuvane. Not only earthly realm. Heavenly and hellish. Everything put together. And subterranean planets. So bhajan, as we said, right? Radha Krishna Padaravinda bhajan. To do that, we are not even qualified. So we are slowly come to that stage. Coming to that stage of performing bhajan for Radha and Krishna. So we are still in the sadhu sangha stage. But if you do properly sadhu sangha, you'll be propelled into bhajana kriya. If you do bhajana kriya and get rid of bad activities like anartha nivritti, then you'll be propelled into the more advanced stages. And that is this book, right? This book is called Nectar of Devotion, which will talk to you about those step-by-step stages. We are just doing the dedication mantra right now. Thus, they are honored all over the three worlds, Tribhuvane, and they are worth taking shelter. Manya Sharanya Karo. So Krishna says, Sarva Dharman Parityajya, Mamekam Sharanam Raja, and chapter 18. If you go to Krishna and says, Krishna, I want to surrender, Krishna will say, get out, you rascal. You are not qualified. Right? For millions of lifetimes, we have been sinful, doing all kinds of bad things, and suddenly you go to Krishna and say, Krishna, accept me. He says, who are you? Get out. So we take sharan of these spiritual masters. Right? Spiritual masters will teach us, train us, they will recommend us to Radharani, then Radharani will recommend us to Krishna. So Dilli Dur Ast. It is very far away. We are still in the Sadhu Sangha stage and we are talking about taking shelter of Krishna, which is so advanced, right? So advanced. Usually that's why it is not possible in one lifetime. So for example, in this lifetime, you'll come to a certain level and then next lifetime, you may be born in a family of practicing sadhakas. And in the following lifetime, you may be born in Vrindavan, to a Brajavasi, and then further improve upon the concepts, and then finally go back. That is the general thinking. At least it takes three lifetimes to go back. Srila Prabhupada said, you can go back in one lifetime if you are serious. But you know, I don't see that level of seriousness in most people. Right? The seriousness means what? Srila Prabhupada told Tamal Krishna, you are going to China to preach. And Tamal Krishna Maharaj was saying, oh, I don't even know Chinese. How will I go? Nothing doing. You have to go. So Tamal Krishna Maharaj goes to China. He learns Chinese and he preaches. Not thinking about family, not thinking about making money, a nice minivan and car. None of that, right? Guru said, go. Just he went. So that level is different and our level is different. So we cannot even pretend to be in that level. Right? We are still asking, oh, Prabhuji, should I fast on this day or not fast on this day? That is Sadhu Sangha level. So from Sadhu Sangha, we have come to Bhajan Kriya, which will take time. Okay, Khushbu Mataji, can you please read this?
Hare Krishna, Prabhu Dandavat Pranam. Can you hear me, na?
Yes, yes, loud and clear.
Okay. Yeah. The Nectar of Devotion is a summary study of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, which was written in Sanskrit by Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada. He was the chief of the six Goswamis who were the direct disciples of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When he first met Lord Chaitanya, Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada was engaged as a minister in the Mohammedan government of Bengal. He and his brother Sanatan were then named Dabir Khas and Sakara Malik respectively, and they held responsible posts as ministers of Nawab Hussain Shah. At that time, 500 years ago, the Hindu society was very rigid, and if a member of the Brahmana caste accepted the service of a Mohammedan ruler, he was at once rejected from Brahmana society. That was the position of the two brothers, Dabir Khas and Sakara Malik. They belonged to the highly situated Saraswata Brahmana community, but they were ostracized due to their acceptance of ministerial posts in the government of Hussain Shah. It is the grace of Lord Chaitanya that he accepted these two exalted personalities as his disciples and raised them to the position of Goswamis, the highest position in Brahmanical culture. Similarly, Lord Chaitanya accepted Haridas Thakur as his disciple, although Haridas happened to be born of a Mohammedan family, and Lord Chaitanya later on made him the Acharya of the chanting of the holy name of the Lord, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I should read more, Prabhu, because there would be a disturbance in my background. My sister is
okay, shouting. We'll have somebody else read. Yeah, Abhishek, can you please read from here?
Hare Krishna. Lord Chaitanya's principle is universal. Anyone who knows the science of Krishna and is engaged in the service of Lord is accepted as being in a higher position than a person born in family of Brahmana. That is the original principle accepted by all Vedic literatures, especially the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. The principle of Lord Chaitanya's movement in educating and elevating everyone to the exalted post of a Goswami is taught in the Nectar of Devotion. Lord Chaitanya met the two brothers, Dabir Khas and Sakar Malik, in a village known as Ramkeli in the district of Malda. And after that meeting, the brothers decided to retire from government service and join Lord Chaitanya. Dabir Khas, who was later to become Rupa Goswami, retired from his post and collected all the money he had accumulated during his service. It is described in Charitamrita that his accumulated savings in gold coins equaled millions of dollars and filled a large pot. He divided the money in a very exemplary manner, which should be followed by devotees in particular and by humanity in general. 50% of his accumulated wealth was distributed to Krishna conscious persons, namely the Brahmins and the Vaishnavas. 25% was distributed to relatives and 25% was kept against emergency expenditures and personal difficulties. Later on, when Sakar Malik also proposed to retire, the Nawab was very much agitated and pulled him into jail. But Sakar Malik, who was later to become Srila Sanatan Goswami, took advantage of his brother's personal money, which had been deposited with a village banker and escaped from the prison of Husainsa. In this way, both brothers joined Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Rup Goswami first met Lord Chaitanya at Prayag, Allahabad, India, and at the Dasashmedh Bathing Ghat of that holy city. The Lord instructed him continually for 10 days. The Lord particularly instructed Rupa Goswami on the science of Krishna consciousness. These teachings of Lord Chaitanya to Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada are narrated in our book, Teachings of Lord Chaitanya. Later, Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada elaborated on the teachings of the Lord with profound knowledge of revealed scriptures and authoritative references from various Vedic literatures. Srila Srinivas Acharya describes in his prayers to the six Goswamis that they were all highly learned scholars, not only Sanskrit, but also in foreign languages such as Persian and Arabic. They very scrutinizingly studied all the Vedic scriptures in order to establish the cult of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu on the authorized principles of Vedic knowledge. The present Krishna consciousness movement is also based on the authority of Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada. We are therefore generally known as Rupanugas or followers in the footsteps of Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada. It is only for our guidance that Srila Rupa Goswami prepared his book Bhakti Rasamitra Sindhu, which is now presented in the form of Nectar of Devotion. Persons engaged in Krishna consciousness movement may take advantage of this great literature and be very solidly situated in Krishna consciousness.
Very good, very good. We'll pause there. So this is the background, right? I mean, the story is pretty long, but in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 paragraphs, it has been described in a summary manner. Right? So this book, Nectar of Devotion, in Sanskrit is called Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Sindhu means ocean. Rasa Amrita means it's an ocean of rasa. Amrita means nectar, right? In the heavenly planets, you get Amrit. So this is Rasamrita. Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. So Nectar of Devotion. That's how Srila Prabhupada translated it into English. So these people, although they were born in Saraswat Brahman families, they more or less behaved like Muslims. They took on Muslim names, Dabir Khan, Sakar Malik, and they were prime ministers of Nawab Hussain Shah. So because they accepted this position under a Muslim, the Brahmana said, no, you no longer belong to Brahman. What these Muslims used to do is they used to cut a cow and take the blood and sprinkle on people. And they say, okay, now that the cow blood has touched your body, you are no longer a Hindu, no longer a Brahman. You are now a Muslim, and they would give them Muslim names and forcibly convert. Right? So India now has what? 25-30% Muslims because of that reason. A lot of people were forcibly converted. All they was just throw some cow blood and said, now from now on, you are a Muslim, like that. So there was a Muslim a gentleman called Haridas Thakur, who became Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's disciple, and he made him, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made him Nam Acharya. So Acharya of the holy name. So holy name, of course, is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So as I was mentioning earlier, some of you joined late, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramanand Rai, they met on the banks of the Godavari River in Rajamundry, originally called Raja Mahendravaram, and they discussed which is the best mantra. And they discussed for days and days, and then finally came to the conclusion that the Hare Krishna mantra is the best mantra for the Kali Yuga, for Kali Kalmasha Nashanam. Right? It's also mentioned in Kali Santarana Upanishad. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Iti Shodaka Namnam Kali Kalmasha Nashanam. So for the Kali Yuga, whatever Kalmash is there, whatever bad stuff, dirty stuff is there, all that would be eliminated by chanting of this mantra, Hare Krishna mantra. So we have to get rid of those kalmash in our heart too. So Kali Kalmasha Nashanam. So which is Iti Shodaka Namnam. Shodaka means 16. Right? Dasha means 10. Shodaka is 16. Ekadasha, 11. So that's why 11 days after the waxing moon and waning moon, we observe fast, the Ekadashi Vrata fast. So we have to fast on those days so that we can get pious credits. Because right now we don't have pious credits, we are unable to move very fast in devotion. So by fasting on Ekadasi, by worshipping Tulsi, Tulsi plant, Tulsi Mata, then we'll get some pious credits to move forward. See, it's a problem, right? It's a challenge is you don't have pious credits, you cannot enter the building. To enter the building, you need pious credits. How do you get them? So by doing Ekadasi fasting, by worshipping Tulsi, you'll get some credits. So the door will open. Then you go inside and then continue your journey of doing more devotion. Otherwise, you're always outside the building. When will you enter? When will you go inside? So then the author, Srila Prabhupada, who's translated this book for us, is saying, Lord Chaitanya's principle is universal. It is not just for Hindus. Anyone who knows the science of Krishna and is engaged in the service of the Lord has being in higher position than a person born in the family of a Brahmana. So if we properly perform devotional service, then we are higher than a Brahmana. That may be sounding strange. Oh, I was not born in a Brahmin family. It doesn't matter. Even if you are born, it's okay. But even if you are not, it doesn't matter at all. So why? Because we are engaged in the seva of the Lord. Service. And the best service is eating prasadam. Or the first service, I should say, not best. Sevon mukahi jivado swayam eva spuradhyataha. So if you do the seva of prasadam with your jihva, tongue, swayam eva, the knowledge will start coming out like a broken dam, how the water comes out, it will come out of your heart. The knowledge is all there in your heart. Paramatma is there in your heart, my heart. But right now it is covered by these various fencing, various barriers, barricades. So we have to bring it out. Chaitanya Charitamrita is a story, basically. The story of all the devotees, how they engaged in the service of the Lord. Gundicha Mardana, right? So how did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu engage his disciples in washing the temple, Gundicha temple in near Puri, right? So Lord Jagannath goes to Gundicha every year for those 15 days and he stays there and he comes back later. That's a tradition that's been going on for thousands of years. What is this principle of Lord Chaitanya's movement? It is educating and elevating everyone to the post of a Goswami. Can you believe it? We can all become Goswamis if we just follow Srila Prabhupada's instructions. Educating, right? We went to college and learned all kinds of junk stuff, accounting, engineering, computer science, this science, that science. But you cannot elevate to Goswami by doing that. If you follow this principle, then you can be elevated to a post of a Goswami. So Goswami is not a title or hereditary. Maybe you're like Mishra, right? Now, maybe your forefathers were into devotion, but it's not hereditary. You will not automatically get it. You have to work for it. Educate and elevate. So this again ties with that shloka in Bhagavad Gita, Chaturvarnam Maya Shrishtam Guna Karma Vibhagasaha. Based on guna, our qualities, and karma, our actions. These four divisions are given by Krishna. Doesn't mean that the Shudra cannot become a Brahmana. You can educate and elevate. Right? Ambedkar was trying to make all the Shudras into Brahmanas. And then they were going through their training day one. Oh, so what should we do? Yeah, you have to wake up at 4 o'clock, take bath and coming to the temple to do seva to the Lord. 50% dropped out right there. 4 o'clock, I wake up at 7 o'clock, they were saying. See that? To be a Brahmana is not easy. So you cannot artificially force a Shudra to be a Brahmana. But if Shudra, after reading Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita, is inspired to do this activity, then they can be elevated. There were some people who did it. Not everybody. Some people do it, like Nammalvar. He was born in a Shudra family in Tamil Nadu. And he is considered the top Alvar. There are many other Alvars. Periyar Alvar, even Goda Devi, she is an Alvar, the lady. So it's not like Indian Bharat system is only for men. This is all this modern hodgepodge that happened, that women had to be suppressed. No, women were always, you know, in a very, very good position. Like Goda Devi was considered an Alvar. A woman is considered an Alvar, like that. So you can elevate to that position, provided you do the work. It's not like I'll say, and Rasgulla should fall in my mouth somehow. There is no milk at home, no sugar. There is no gas cylinder to cook the Rasgulla. And you say, and will the Rasgulla fall in your mouth? So like that, right? So basically you have to work for it. You have to do the process of chanting, do the process of seva. If you are not allowed to get onto the altar, which you are not normally, until you take Brahminical initiation, you can clean the pots, clean the temple floor. There's always seva. Or come to our farm and work there. So there are different ways of doing it. So this educating and elevating is the most important. Actually, Srila Prabhupada says it all. Actually, every sentence of Srila Prabhupada, he gives everything. Like if you look at this sentence, right? Lord Chaitanya's principle is universal, which means the entire world can take it. The principle of Lord Chaitanya's movement in educating and elevating everyone to exalted post of Goswami is taught in Nectar of Devotion. So forget the East taught. Just look at this till here. The entire philosophy is there. Educate yourself and elevate yourself. Elevating includes no drinking alcohol, no eating meat, fish or eggs, no getting illicit hanky-panky outside of marriage, no gambling, and no speculation. Gambling and philosophical speculation. Maybe God is like this. No, there's no maybe. You have to come to scriptures. That is, if you start doing maybe, it will become like Christianity. Most Christians, 99%, have no clue what is written in the Bible only. Thanks to Prabhupada, many of Prabhupada's disciples and grand disciples know what Bible is better than Christians themselves. Right? I read the Bible and I'm like, wow, there's so much information here. And then you got to talk to an average guy. He'll have his baseball cap ulta. He'll be drinking beer and eating a burger. That means he's not even a Shudra. To be a Shudra, you need to have some qualities. He's a Chandala. Chandala means one step lower than Shudra. Right? And America is full of Chandalas because everybody is drinking beer and eating meat. So if you educate and elevate, anybody can. Nammalvar was born in Shudra family. He got elevated. I'm not born in a Brahmin family. I'm getting elevated, right? So be taking birth in a spiritual family is not necessary. Your willingness to work to elevate yourself is more important than taking birth alone. So then there is a story about the gold coins. So the gold coins that Rupa Goswami got filled a large boat. Why is Prabhupada saying this? Any thoughts? Why is Prabhupada saying it? Is money so important? Bolo, Sangha. Kaho. Because he divided the money in an exemplary manner. 50% he gave for charity, for temples, Brahmanas, Vaishnavas. Only 25% he gave to his relatives, wife, kids, grandkids. So if you have $1 million, 50% for charity, 250,000 for family, 250,000 for emergency. So it's not like he said, be reckless. No, 25% was for emergencies. So this is a very nice formula. At any given point, 50% for charity, 25% for relatives. Then maybe people may say, oh, no. Why do you have to give charity to that Mota Pandit and you are only giving me dal and roti to eat at home? It's not like that. It is like there is a certain formula so that you can peacefully chant Hare Krishna. If you see very rich people, they don't chant. Why? Because they think the money will come and save them at the time of death. Right? Do you think Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, Bill Gates, who are the rich people in India? Singhania, Tatas, Birlas are chanting Hare Krishna? No, Birlas do a good little bit of temple building, but not really deep devotion. It is difficult, right? When you are very wealthy. So that's why when you give away half of it at any given point, then you have very little left. So you're not proud. That is the philosophy. So what happened? Rupa Goswami did this. His brother later said, oh, Nawabji, I want to retire. He said, nothing doing. He said, no, I want to retire. No, I'll put you in jail. So then he took advantage of Rupa Goswami's money, bribed some jailers and escaped. Then both of them went to Vrindavan. Of course, before that, Rupa Goswami met in Prayag, right? Do you know the story of Prayag? Recently, until recently, it was called something else. What was it called?
Allahabad.
Allahabad, yeah. So who forced the change of name from Allahabad to Prayag? Yogi Adityanath. Yeah, chief minister. He's like a very, go and see his videos on YouTube. He's like a real Kshatriya. He takes no nonsense, right? He'll blast people left and right. So Allahabad became Prayagraj. And we need Kshatriyas. What happened is the Varnashrama system became so messed up. India was left without Kshatriyas. So there were a few like Rajputs were there, Prithviraj Chauhan, people like that. There were a few like Shivaji, there were a few in the south like Cholas and Cheras. But broadly that concept went out and then all these invaders came and kind of occupied India and then rest is history. So Prayag, there is a Dasa Swamedha Ghat. Like a lot of people still take their departed souls to this ghat and burn them. So why did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu give instruction at a place where dead bodies are burnt? Gopal?
I believe everybody loses their ego there.
Yeah, excellent. That was Abhishek, right? You answered?
Yes.
Very nice. Yeah. So basically when you're dying, your wealth doesn't matter. And that is the place to teach renunciation. Vairagya. There is a concept of Smashan Vairagya. Anybody knows what that is? Smashan Vairagya?
Yes, Prabhu, that's Shamshan Vairagya. Right. That when we see somebody dead in front of our eyes, then we become renunciate for a particular, for a period of time.
Right, only for a couple of days. After that again, we become very materialistic, right? And because, you know, my relatives also passed away, some of them, I went to Smashan, I carried their body, put them on the pyre. So 1 or 2 days we say, oh, what is this? What is the meaning of life? Like that, we become very philosophical. But that doesn't last, unfortunately. And it will last if you continue to read scriptures and say that this human body is nothing but five elements joined together and the soul is put in these five elements, right? So what is human body? Earth, water, fire, air, and ether. So earth will go back to earth. Water will go back to water. So all the indriyas are reclaimed and the soul goes to next body or goes to narak, hell, or goes to heaven, or better is go to spiritual world. So, but this Smashan Vairagya doesn't last very long. I mean, it has not lasted with me. It has not lasted with many other people. I've seen that. But if you read scriptures every day, Srila Prabhupada will remind you again and again that our position in the material world is very flaky. Very, very flaky means anything can happen at any time. So, yesterday, day before yesterday, one of my son's classmates brought a gun to the class. Everybody was scared. They ran helter-skelter. My son came home. Of course, they didn't suspend that kid for whatever reason, but they took away his weapon. And last Friday, there was a shooting in one exactly a week ago in South Center Mall, where you have JCPenney, Macy's. So there was this 19-year-old black girl standing outside. So one guy comes in the car and he tries to shoot another gang's person. One stray bullet comes and hits this girl and she's dead. So life is very cheap in this world. The people will shoot even for $50. Right? So we have to understand that either one way or the other, you have to understand that life is very temporary here and then act on that platform. Very difficult for us because we are only saints during this 1 hour Bhagavad Gita class. After that, again, we go back, hey, kya ho raha? Oh, yeah, very good, very good. Let's eat some aloo paratha and watch Amitabh Bachchan movie. We become like that. That is the covering potency of Maya. Right? Maya does two things. One is avarnatmika shakti, prakshetatmika shakti. Prakshetatmika is throwing, avarnatmika is covering. That is the job of Maya. She does her job very well. Maya is what? Shiva's wife, very, very pious lady. Oh, by the way, I was telling earlier today to someone, Shiva doesn't give Maya 10,000 square foot apartment, refrigerator, washing machine, Tesla car. They sit in the open in the cold and Shiva is meditating and Parvati is attending to him, looking at him and smiling. So a lesson to all of us, right? We crave for small, small things, but Parvati herself doesn't have all these facilities. Have you ever seen a picture of Shiva and Parvati in a 5-bedroom home, air-conditioned home like that? No? Have you seen that? You know what I'm talking about? You know who Shiva and Parvati are? Nobody knows? I bet you know, but you're just shy. Okay. So look at him. He is wearing loincloth and she's just with her outer clothing. That's it. And they're outside in the open all the time. You never see them in a mall. You never see them anywhere like that, right? You always see them in the open. Always in the open. And she doesn't complain. She doesn't say, hey, G, what is going on? You are not providing me with all the facilities. Huh? She never says that. But her job is very well executed. She will keep all the souls in check in the material world, including you and me. Right? So during this Bhagavad Gita class, we are all very inspired and we leave the class and again, we go back to our own mundane. Mundane means ordinary activities. Srila Prabhupada loves this word, mundane, because almost everybody is mundane. Right? So we are under this grip of Maya. And this instruction is given on a Smashan Ghat. that's a Swamedha Ghat. You can go there. I was there on the way to Badrinath. How many years ago? 12, 13 years ago. Amazing, like the Ganga Aarti that happens in the evening. And from there, as you are going to Badrinath, you go through Himalayas. You will see, like, there'll be Ganga flowing, and there will be one person with a towel around his waist and will be sitting next to Ganga. That's it. And then one person was trying to make fire. One sadhu was trying to make fire with 3 or 4 wooden pieces. So we are nowhere close to that level of thinking. So the teaching of Lord Chaitanya are in a different book, Teachings of Lord Chaitanya, right? On the Vedavyas, you can go and review it. Or $2 in our temple, you can buy that book. So later, Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada, Prabhupada means at the feet where spiritual masters sit. So he sat at the feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and his disciples sat at his feet. So what did he do? Elaborate on the teaching with profound knowledge of revealed scriptures. So revealed scripture is a very important thing. Scriptures are to be revealed, not man-made. They are apaurusheya, means human beings don't make them. They are revealed by the Lord. Like Brahma in the form of Hayagriva comes and he, as he's breathing, these scriptures come out through the potency of Saraswati, his consort. Right? So they don't have to sit down and write. But of course, some of them have been written, like Srimad Bhagavatam, as Veda Vyas was dictating, Ganeshji was writing it down. So if you go to Badrinath, Upper Badrinath, where I've been with Tamal Krishna Maharaj's disciple, Sannyasi disciple, there is a Ganesh Gufa, there is a Vyas Gufa. Ganesh Gufa is at a higher elevation, Vyas Gufa is a little lower. And as he is dictating, Ganeshji is writing. That's how we have Srimad Bhagavatam documented. Previously, people used to just ekasandagrahi, means once you say, they will absorb everything. But due to passage of time, Kali Yuga means loss of memory. In the Canto 11, it says, Tatascha anudhinam dharma, satyam saucham kshama dhaya, kalena balina rajan, nungshutu ayu balam smritihi. Nungshutu means getting down, ayu, lifespan goes down. Balam, strength goes down. Smritihi, memory goes down. Right? We all studied when we were young, we had paper and pencil and we used to write everything. Now everything is in mobile and you don't know even your sister's mobile number. You have to look it up. True? So Kali Yuga means everything is going down. Therefore, at the beginning of Kali Yuga, all of these things were documented. Vyasji was reciting and Ganeshji was writing it down about 5,050 years ago, coinciding with departure of Lord Krishna. So as Lord Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam says, was departing, the sun of Krishna was departing, the moon of Srimad Bhagavatam was coming up. So the Srimad Bhagavatam gives us that level of information. So even with Krishna absent on this material planet, we still have Krishna in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavate Mahamunikrite Kimba Parerishvaraha Sadhyo Hridi Avarudyate Kritibi Takshanat. Means if you start reading Srimad Bhagavatam Takshanat, within a second, that spiritual knowledge is getting infused in you. What you do with the knowledge is a different matter, but at least the knowledge is coming. So there's so much knowledge to be learned. You are all in kindergarten, first grade right now. We have to go to PhD. But of course, you don't need too much knowledge. We don't want to be gyanis. We want to be bhaktas. Bhaktas means devotees. Bhakti means devotional service. So can anybody tell me the difference between devotion and devotional service?
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Yeah. A devotional service, by devotional service means we have to engage our body, mind and words, manasa, karmana and vacha in the service. It doesn't mean, and Prabhupada that actually coined this term, devotional service. It we have to be, I mean, this is something which intrigued me also. Because if we don't do anything, then we are not able to, it's actually an expression of our love towards the Lord. When we do something for somebody, like in the mundane world also, when a father earns money for his family, he's doing so much, I mean, toiling so much, because he loves his family. So just saying won't do. We have to express, and the expression of love is devotional service. That's what Prabhupada gave us. So I just said that. If anybody wants to add,
very nice, very nice. You are a very eloquent speaker. So very well, well said. So for the reference, Kushbu Mataji is in Kolkata right now. She'll be moving to Mayapur. So she is very close to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birthplace right now. So you can see the potency of her words, how they come out. So Abhishek, any thoughts on that one?
I think I agree, like the manifesting the devotion is the devotion service. Like you can be devoted, but like how you are manifesting that, you have to manifest in some kind of service.
Right. And then, but why? What is the fundamental hypothesis here? Why not just devotion? Why do we have to do devotional service? Jaipal, why not just do pure devotion? Why do you have to do service?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
So why do we have to do devotional service and not just do pure devotion? Straightforward. Okay, audio problems.
When you engage in devotional service only, you will you'll be humble and you'll be
You're beating around the bush. But I see where you're going. When you do devotional service, you feel devotion. You right. Get the corollary to the theorem. What is the theorem? Why not just devotion?
Prabhu, is it something to do with the human ego?
Yes. And add to it.
And Prabhuji, maybe another interpretation, Abhishek here. I feel like maybe you can be devoted to your spouse, your family, but I think to Lord, definitely it's like we are all servants, right?
Yes. So
we need to be like, we can't be equals to him, or we are not relatives to him. So we had to be like a devotional service, not like a devotion as we do with like our family members, we are devoted.
Yeah, that's an excellent point. Excellent point. Very well said. In addition, I'm looking for one more point that has to do with our psychological, emotional, social state right now.
It tells us when we serve for Lord unconditionally, the goal and the purpose of our life. And the main goal is to go back to home, go back to Godhead. And maybe?
Yeah, you mentioned the motivation. Yes, to go back to God. All that is correct. but you still did not answer the fundamental question, why devotional service and not just straightforward devotion. All of your answers are correct, everybody, but you're still beating around the bush.
Prabhu, Anisha has to add something.
Okay, Anisha, go ahead.
I think it might be because devotional service kind of keeps our mind focused on God and focused on like doing things for God and like loving God. Devotional service kind of helps us.
Yes, excellent point. Abhishek and Anisha hit on the key points there. So let me finish up that thought. Devotion is not possible because our mind is always wavering. In Kali Yuga, we don't have the resources. We don't have the social structure. Who is a Brahmana? If you go onto the street to Safeway or to QFC, do you see any Brahmana guiding you? This is not possible, right? So the structure has broken to a certain extent, to a large extent, that you cannot do straightforward devotion, for example, done by Narsi Mehta or Tukaram, or to a certain degree by Guru Nanak or by Mirabai. So devotional movement started 550 years ago in India. But that kind of devotion is not possible right now. I mean, devotion is the nature and quality of the soul eternally, right? For millions of lifetimes. I was saying 550 years ago in modern times. That's when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started this Sankirtan movement, because the classic devotion is impossible. You cannot even say, let me try. No, it's impossible. Like, where are you going to sit and meditate without getting disturbed? Especially if you are in Kolkata, there is no place to meditate. It's continuous noise. Hyderabad, continuous noise. Right? So therefore, Srila Prabhupada not only coined the linguistic term devotional service, but he emphasized the practical aspect of that. Right? So washing dishes for Krishna in the temple is devotional service, because you cannot sit and digest, assimilate a Bhagavad Gita class. That's what Jaipal does all the time. The temple is there moving items, cleaning, and Disha, you need to get into that. Unless you wash pots in the temple, humility will not develop. People will say, hey, come on, wash this pot. So you think, oh, how dare he say, I am the proprietor of this UPS store. And he's saying, hey, wash this pot. Humility develops when we are humbled.
Prabhu, I've already done. Jaipal has already put me, Jaipal Prabhu has already put
me. Okay, do more.
Yes, I am already on the right path.
Okay, very good.
Heading that direction. Thank you so much for the motivation.
Yeah, I think Gopal is escaping. Jaipal, you should engage Gopal more.
Gopal Prabhu does a lot of service, Prabhuji. He does
maybe
part
he
one.
He should do more. I mean,
yeah.
Put him into burrito service. Sankirtan burrito service. Sheshadev also seems to be absconding these days. Put him in some service.
Sheshadev Prabhu Mataji does Sunday 3 to 5.
Okay. Oh, that. How many hours are there in a week? 174 hours. And he comes for my Nagar Sankirtan for 4 hours. So
yes, we have empty slots, Prabhuji. And on weekdays, we need volunteers.
Okay. Sheshadev, the book is open. And then actually, Devesh should also start doing some service once he is vaccinated. Right? He is a young boy, right? Muscles are built not by going to the gym. Muscles are built when you wash Krishna's pots. Has anybody seen the movie Kung Fu of Seven Steps? So, okay, you guys are too young for that. This movie happened like 35, 40 years ago when I was a teenager. So in that movie, this fellow goes to the guru, to the ashram of Kung Fu ashram in China. Says, I want to learn Kung Fu. The guru takes the sticks, beats him and says, go to the, take these buckets and go to the well and get water. So the poor fellow for 1 year is only getting water. Then he says, I want to learn Kung Fu. He says, what? Your body is not strong enough. Go get more water. right? So don't think knowledge is just imparted just like that and it is free and cheap. You have to first physically work for Krishna, right? I mean, and now I don't do it. So you may say, why are you not doing, Prabhu? But in my young age, I've done it. So you have to physically do service for Krishna. And 2 weekends ago, I went and went to our farm in Arlington and painted the farmhouse. Myself, Garuda, and Garuda's wife, Garuda Prabhu and Garuda Prabhu's wife. 3 of us and my nephew, 4 of us, we went there and we painted. Our hands were dirty, our clothes were dirty. But yeah, we have to do physical service for Krishna. So the farm was purchased for Krishna. So the farmhouse is Krishna's property. Right? It takes 1.5 hours to go, 1.5 hours to come, 4 hours of painting. We were dead tired. So you have to physically work for Krishna. Like you see all these IIT walas, mechanical engineering, computer science, they become brahmacharis. I saw one of them. He took a big pot. He was in the temple kitchen in Tirupati, ISKCON, and he was making khichdi. I said, Prabhuji, what's going on? Yes, Prabhu, I have to make this khichdi. He forgot his mechanical engineering. He forgot everything, physics. Although he's a brilliant guy, he's making khichdi for Krishna. Physical work. Because this is a physical process, right? It is not like like jnani. Jnani is just read some scriptures and just imagine stuff. Aisa nahi hoga. Kaam karna padega. Physically. Right? So again, I've told Abhishek, we have just ordered a lot of wood. We have ordered 700 posts. Now we have to go to the farm and mount those posts in the ground. So there's a lot of work coming up. Abhishek lives in Mill Creek, which is close to Arlington. So I asked him to join me when we go. We just ordered them today. So I don't know when they are coming. Maybe on the weekend, maybe middle of the week. So we have to go during our holidays. Then everything slows down at work. We'll go and plant these posts in our farm and then put fencing around it so that mother cow can come there and she can graze. We have 47 acres of nice pasture land. Pasture means all the trees have been cut and only grass is there for grazing. When you have trees, it's called forest. When you have grass, it's called pasture. So a lot of work to be done for Krishna. Jai. Kushbu Mataji is saying Jai. Yeah, so much to do. We have 2 farms here, Mataji. One north of the city, one south of the city. So in both places, we have cows. I mean, in one place we have cows, second place we will have cows. Some of these cows will move there. So that's what it is. This is a practical movement. It is not a, you know, PhD thesis movement where you just read books and write some papers, although I do that. But you should not do that because your life cycle is different than mine, right? So you are all much younger to me. So you have to physically apply your energy to serving Krishna. Srila Prabhupada said, work now, samadhi later. What does that mean? Sheshdev.
Samadhi later.
Work now, samadhi later. What does that mean?
Actually, I think when you have the energy, dedicate that energy to Krishna, because yeah. Keep postponing, you will not be able to.
Yeah, think about meditation and samadhi later. Then when you are old and body doesn't move, sit in one place and chant 64 rounds. But now, work for Krishna physically. Right? Okay. Any closing thoughts?
Hari Bol, Prabhu. I'm amazing. I mean, I'm just overwhelmed by hearing so nice service carrying on. Like even I was engaged in making rangolis and alpuna, and that really, it takes so much time. But then after the rangoli is done, the alpuna is done, the beautiful, it's so beautiful. And then we feel that happiness. And that happiness that which is I mean which pushes us, and it becomes it's another kind of happiness. So if we do something from our, I mean, we should start with our body, because as you said, we are so much affected by the mundane and by the worldly things that we need to do. We need to, I mean, I really like that line, muscles are built by serving Krishna. I'll write it down in my notebook. It's something very nice. Thank you so much, Prabhu.
Haribol. Yeah, it's all coming from the parampara. I didn't coin that term. It's all coming from parampara. Evam parampara praptam evam rajashayo vidhu, right? It all came from Prabhupada. Prabhupada was extremely practical. He used to cook himself, right, for his disciples. So, yeah, we have to follow our acharyas and everything will be good. Okay, so in the next 10 minutes, let's chant one round and then we'll call it a day. Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Prabhu Nityanandam. Shri Advaita Gadadharam. Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. And now let's chant. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna,
So that ends our round. Any final thoughts before we disband for the day? By the way, I'm so fortunate to have all of you because you are here to engage in a conversation, I'm able to think about Krishna. So otherwise I'll be talking to an empty wall. So by your presence, I am becoming Krishna conscious.